Well, you saw his courageous crawl to the finish line in this year's Boston Marathon as the crowd was chanting his name.
Yeah, that video going viral. It's an inspiring story of strength and perseverance. And this morning, Tallmadge native and Marine veteran Michael Herndon joins us to tell us more about the experience. First of all, thank you for serving our country. And we are so proud of you. And the fact that you're local, we're like, oh my gosh. And breaking news, which some of you may have heard, but you have been invited to the New York City Marathon.
Yeah. Whenever I was getting interviewed, Robin Roberts, she surprised me with that, and it was pretty good. Didn't really know what to say, but I'm grateful and thankful for it.
How has your life changed since that marathon, man?
We left, when we left, it was Saturday morning around 3 o'clock, and we drove all the way to Boston, and, you know, when I left, I'm just a bearded short dude, you know, from here. And now it's blown up to be what it is. And what I'm most proud of is I'm getting the names out there of my brothers that I lost.
And talk about them.
You know, Matthew Ballard, Mark Juarez, Rupert Hamer. When we lost them, you know, on the IED strike, you know, it definitely stuck with me, and you know, that's the reason why I run, is for them.
Yeah.
And you know, whatever pain I'm going through at that time, you know, throughout any race or any of my workouts, whenever I'm working out in the morning,
yeah.
You know, it doesn't compare to what they felt, you know, at that time.
And one of those, two were service members. One was a journalist.
Yes, British journalist. One of the other guys that was in that vehicle, he was an urgent casualty. He worked alongside the other British journalist.
And this was in?
Afghanistan, yeah.
And so you have said that you've dealt with PTSD, and is running kind of your cup?
Yeah, you know, I tried other things, you know, working out, fishing, and hunting and stuff like that. But running really stuck with me because it, you could just go in your zone, really. You know, that runner's high, it releases all those endorphins, and you can just get away from everyday, you know, everyday life.
Now, how many marathons have you run?
Boston was my third.
That was your third one?
That was only your third one?
Wow. Yeah.
Usually people work their way up to that.
Yeah. Because we're talking 26 miles, right?
Yeah.
26.2.
So when you were running and you were, you know, and you got down on your hands and knees and were crawling, what's going through your mind at that point?
You know, I, around mile 20, that's where my family was posted up, and they posted that video, and I really didn't even look at them because I was just so focused on really trying to finish it out as best as I could.
Yeah.
And that's around there, that's when my one of the legs started to lock up, and then around mile 22, that's when really both of them locked up, and then right there, my mile times, you know, they suffered.
They're trying to help you up, but you're like, what? And that was one of the service members trying to help you up.
Yeah, I had a couple people try to help me up, and, you know, I just wanted to finish on my own. And, you know, but I couldn't move my legs forward, so the next best option is to crawl. And, you know.
So what you thinking, man? What keeps you going? What kept you going?
I had tunnel vision just to finish. And what kept me going was just I kept repeating those names just like I always do.
Yeah.
You know, Ballard, Hamer, Juarez, Ballard, Hamer, Juarez, my brothers that we lost. And and that just gives me, you know, whatever pain I'm going through is nothing compared to what they went through and what their families went through.
Wow.
I love how you brought your stuff.
Yeah.
Super cool.
That's you ran in those.
So these are the...
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm surprised they're still in one piece. That's a long way to run, man.
They're, I tried them out. They're pretty good. They're not bad. But, I got the medal there. I finally, afterwards, I didn't get the medal right away because they took me to an aid station. Got cleared up from them.
So if you finish, you get the medal.
Yeah, they're supposed to put it on around your neck.
Talk about on the shoe. You have the names of your comrades.
Yeah, my wife got me those just to remember. You know, just another. You know, when
another
I'm looking
reminder.
Down, or if you know. Just
so you
another.
Were running and looking down at your.
Wow. Whenever I'm, you know, doing hill work or climbing hills, or any grade going up, I tend to look down. So
now you seem still a little bit sore.
Yeah.
When
yeah.
he came walking in the studio. So, but the New York City Marathon is not till November. So you have time, right?
November 3rd.
Training starts when?
Probably next week.
So okay.
I'm one of these.
And your mom and your sister are here. I mean, yeah. What a great support group.
And when I heard you were from this area, man, I was so
I know,
so
I love it.
Proud.
I love that you're here from here.
Because I saw the video, but then when I found out you were from our area, I'm like, yeah, that's good stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
He only watches local news. If any national shows are going to see this,
down.
He didn't know who you are.
Fox 8 News. Come on.
We're kidding.
Yeah, it's just
shameless plug.
No, it's you meet a lot of different people so fast, and your phone's constantly going off, and really,
well deserved.
Didn't really know who's out there, you know. So
yeah, we're
stuff,
so proud
man.
Of you.
Thank you
that.
For your service, my friend.
I appreciate it.
And
that.
Good luck in New York City.
Oh, yeah.
Come back
so
and
much.
Talk to us about it.
Yeah. I'll let you know how it was. So.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.